Welcome to a lesson on the zero exponent. If we start by looking at the exponent rules given here on the right, notice that we're given that a to the zero power is equal to 1 as long as the base a doesn't equal 0. Before we take a look at our examples though, I think it's important that we understand why a to the zero is equal to 1. So we're going to justify this rule several ways before we take a look at these examples. We'll first take a look at raising 2 to various powers and 3 to various powers. We're going to start with 2 to the fourth and then decrease the exponent by 1 all the way down to 2 to the power of negative 2. Well, we should recognize that 2 to the fourth is 2 times 2 times 2 times 2, or 4 factors of 2, which is equal to 16. And also 2 to the third, or 2 times 2 times 2, is equal to 8. But notice how the pattern to go from 16 to 8 would be to divide by 2, since 2 to the third has one less factor of 2. 2 to the second, or 2 squared, is equal to 2 times 2, or 4. Notice how 8 divided by 2 is also equal to 4. And then we have 2 to the first, which is equal to 2. And again, notice that 4 divided by 2 is equal to 2. And now we have 2 to the zero, which by definition is equal to 1. But also notice how the pattern continues. 2 divided by 2 is equal to 1. This also explains why negative exponents result in fractions. 2 to the power of negative 1 is equal to 1/2, because 1 divided by 2 is equal to 1/2. And 2 to the power of negative 2 is equal to 1/4. Notice that 1/2 divided by 2 is equal to 1/4. And of course, this pattern would be true for any non-zero base. Notice if we take a look at the base of 3, 3 to the fourth is equal to 4 factors of 3, or 81, and 3 to the third is equal to 27. Notice how 81 divided by 3 is equal to 27. 3 to the second is equal to 9, and 27 divided by 3 is also equal to 9. 3 to the first is equal to 3, and 9 divided by 3 is also 3. And here we have 3 to the zero again, which we know is equal to 1, because 3 divided by 3 is equal to 1. 3 to the power of negative 1 is equal to 1/3, and 1 divided by 3 is equal to 1/3. And then finally, 3 to the power of negative 2 is equal to 1/9, and 1/3 divided by 3 is equal to 1/9. Let's also justify this rule using our properties of exponents. For example, if we consider 2 raised to the power of 3 times 2 to the 0, we know when multiplying and the bases are the same, the rule is to add the exponents. So if we add the exponents, we would have 2 raised to the power of 3 plus 0, which of course is just equal to 2 to the third. So if 2 to the third times 2 to the 0 is equal to 2 to the third, the only way that's going to be true is if 2 to the 0 is equal to 1. And then in this second row here, we have the same rule for any base a where a doesn't equal 0. And now for one more justification, let's consider 3 raised to the power of 0, which must be equal to 3 raised to the power of negative 2 plus 2, because negative 2 plus 2 is still 0. And then by applying this product rule here in the opposite direction, we can write this as a product. This would be 3 to the power of negative 2 times 3 to the power of positive 2. And then to write 3 to the power of negative 2 with a positive exponent, we would move it to the denominator. So this 3 to the power of negative 2 is equal to 3 to the second in the denominator, which notice gives us 3 to the second over 3 to the second, or 9 over 9, which must equal 1. And therefore 3 to the 0 must equal 1. And then again, the second row here is just the most general case, again where x would not equal 0. So now going back to our examples, hopefully we have a better understanding why any non-zero base raised to the zero power must equal 1. And as we go through these, there is one example we have to be very careful about, and that's going to be this last one. Again, 2 to the 0 is equal to 1. Then looking at the second example, there's no reason to evaluate this inner expression since it's raised to the zero power, and therefore it's equal to 1. 4x to the third raised to the zero power must equal 1, again as long as x doesn't equal 0. Our fourth example, the same thing, this expression is raised to the 0 power. As long as this expression is not 0, this is equal to positive 1. Next we have negative 7 raised to the 0 power. Notice how the negative 7 is in parentheses. Our base is non-zero, and therefore this is equal to 1. But for this last example, we have to be very careful because this is the opposite of positive 7 raised to the 0 power. This exponent of 0 is only attached to the positive 7, not the negative 7, unlike the previous example. And therefore, this is going to be equal to the opposite of 7 to the 0 power, which is actually negative 1, not positive 1. You can think of the negative as not being attached to the exponent, and therefore the result is going to be negative 1. Okay, I hope you found this helpful.